Good evening, students. We are in the chapter factorization. Till now we have completed from exercise 14.2 first me. Now let us do second me. So before starting doing the sums, let us just have a quick recap of the identities, what and all we have learned. We know a plus b the whole squared is a squared plus b squared plus 2ab. Next, we have a minus b the whole squared. A minus b the whole squared is a squared plus b squared minus 2ab. Next, we have a plus b into a minus b is a squared minus b squared. Then we have x plus a into x plus b is x squared plus x into a plus b plus ab. So using these four identities only, we are going to factorize. So in the first main, factorize this following expression. We have used a plus b the whole squared and a minus b the whole squared. Okay. So now from the second main, we will start doing the factorization. So our question starts. 4p squared minus 9q squared. So, can you able to realize this part? 4p squared, we can make it as 2p the whole squared minus 3q the whole square. So, I'm going to make now 4p squared minus 9q squared. We will make it as 2p the whole squared because 2 squared is 4p squared minus 9q the whole squared. We can make it as 3q the whole squared. We made it as a squared minus b squared form where we have a is 2p, b is 3q. So what we know about a squared minus b squared identity, a plus b into a minus b. So I can say you, this is of the form a squared minus b squared is equal to a plus b into a minus b, where our a is 2b, b is 3q. So I'm going to substitute here. So this will become 2p the whole squared minus 3q the whole squared is 2p plus 3q, a plus b into a minus b, 2p minus 3q. That is what we have done. The question is 4p squared minus 9q squared. So 4p squared minus 9q squared, we first rewrite as 2p the whole squared minus 3q the whole squared. So we brought it into the form of identity a squared minus b squared, which you know a plus b into a minus b. So this will become 2p plus 3q into 2p minus 3q. Okay. First sum, this in detailed we are doing it. So next sum onwards, let us start doing first. First sum again, 4p squared minus 9q squared. 4p squared can be written as 2p the whole squared. So that 2 squared 4p squared. Minus 9q squared can be written as 3q the whole square. 9 can be written as 3 squared. 3 squared is 9q squared. So this looks like our identity a squared minus b squared, which is a plus b into a minus b, where your a is 2p, b is 3q. So we write a square minus b square 2p whole square minus 3q the whole square as a plus b into a minus b, which is 2p plus 3q multiplied by 2p minus 3q. So the given question 4p squared minus 9q square, we rewrite as 2p the whole square minus 3q the whole square, which looks to our identity as a square minus b square. So it is a plus b into a minus b. Hope you would have understood this. So we'll follow the method for the remaining sum like that. Okay. Next sum. 63 a square minus 112 b square. Now, when you see 63, 63 is not a perfect square to write, is it not? So what we do for 63 and 112, we try to split. 63 can be written as 7 nines are 63 a square minus 112 can be written as, in 112 with 7 you multiply and see, you get 16b squared. 63 can be split into 7 nines are 63. I'll write the numbers inside the bracket, a squared. 112 can be written as 7 into 16 b squared. Now you can see in both the terms 7 is common. So we can take out the 7 out. So when we take 7 out, what we have? 9 a squared minus 16 b squared. Okay. We remove the 7. It is a common term. So when we take out the common term, in the first term, 9a squared is left minus, in second term, 16b squared is left. Now, let the 7 be like this. This 9a squared, how can we write? Shall we write as 3a the whole square? So that 3 squared is 9a squared minus 16b squared. 16 can be written as 4b the whole square. So, 9a squared minus 16b squared has been written as 3a the whole square minus 4b square. Now this is in the form of a square minus b square, where this is a, 3a is a, this is b, 4b is b. Therefore, we can write 7 into a square minus b square is what? A plus b, 3a plus 4b into 3a minus 4b. So the 7 common term is like that. Then a square minus b square we split into a plus b into a minus b. So our question, 63 a square minus 112 b square is factorized into 7 into 3a plus 4b into 3a minus 4b. Okay. So when you don't have a straight away the square number, you should see which number you have to take the factor. Common factor you have to take out. If you take the common factor, then we get the perfect square number, which we can rewrite as a square minus b square and factorize into a plus b into a minus b. Next, third subdivision. Third subdivision, 49x squared minus 36. So, 49x squared minus the 49 is also perfect square. 36 also square. So, shall we write it as 7x the whole squared minus 6 square? So, this is a, this 6 is b. A squared minus b squared. What is a squared minus b squared? A plus b into a minus b. So, 49x squared minus 36 is factorized into 7x plus 6 multiplied by 7x minus 6. Next, fourth sum. 16x power 5 minus 144x to the power of 3. Now, when we see the number 16, we know it is 4 squared. 144, we know 12 squared. But we have this variable power 5 and power 3 where we can't make it as perfect square. So, we take the common variable. So, 16x power 5. So, whenever we want to take common, we take the least power out. No. So, can we take it as x power 5 as x power 3 into x power 2 minus 144x cube. I am splitting the highest power in terms of the least power. So, I can see now x cube is common. We will take it out. So, we have 16x squared minus 144 because x cube already we have taken out. So, when we taken out x cube, in the first term, 16x squared is left. In the second term, only 144 left. So this we can write as 6x cube. 16x squared is 4x the whole squared minus 144 is 12 squared. So for us now this is A, this is B. So we factorize x cube into 4x plus 12 into 4x minus 12. So what we have done in this sum? We find the numbers are perfect square, but the variables are not. So common variable, common terms we take out. So we write the bigger exponent in terms of smaller exponent. Here we have smaller one is x cube. So x power 5 can be written as x cube into x squared. So we can see x cube is common in both the term. We take it out. We'll open a bracket. And we see in the first term, 16x squared is left. We write. Minus sign is given in the question. Next in the second term, x cube already we have taken. So only 144. So now we can see inside the bracket it is in perfect square. 4x the whole squared minus 144 12 squared. So we have x cube a squared minus b as x cube 4x plus 12 into 4x minus 12. So which we can return as the factorization 16x power 5 minus 144 x cube as x cube into 4x plus 12 into 4x minus 12. Now let us do fifth subdivision. Fifth one, we have L plus M the whole square minus of L minus M the whole squared. So here we can see this is L plus M the whole square minus L minus M the whole square. So what we do? This full term we consider it as A. This L minus M full term we considered it as B. So that this looks like see A square minus B squared, where A is L plus M, B is L minus M. So this using the identity A squared minus B squared. Therefore, A squared minus B squared is what? A plus B into A minus B. A, L plus M, A plus B, L minus M. A plus B into A minus B. A minus of B, L minus M. So what we have now? We will simplify. L plus M plus L minus M. We remove this bracket. Again, L plus M. This minus when we take inside, minus L, minus minus, plus M. Now we see plus M, minus M get cancelled. Plus M, minus M, opposite sign, it will get cancelled. L plus L is 2L. Here, plus L, minus L get cancelled into 2M. What is 2L into 2M? 2 2's are, we multiply the numbers, 4, L into M, L, M. So this is our solution. This I'll repeat once again. Your question is L plus M the whole square minus of L minus M the whole square. See the question you have. L plus M the whole square minus of L minus M the whole square. So what happens? We have L plus M the whole square as A minus of L minus M as B. So A squared minus B squared. In place of A, we have L plus M. In place of B, we have L minus M. So, what we have? A plus B into A minus B. So, A, L plus M, A plus B. So, if you want, I can write here. This is A plus B and this is A minus B. So, that A is L plus M, B is L minus M. Again, A is L plus M, B is L minus M. So, now what happens? L plus M plus L minus M is minus M plus M get cancelled. L plus L, 2L. Here, when we take minus inside, L plus M minus L minus minus plus M. So, plus L and minus L get cancelled. M plus M is 2M. So, 2L into 2M. 2 2s are 4. L into M, LM. Okay. Next. Let us do question number 6. We have question number 6. 9x squared y squared minus 16. 6th question. 9x squared y squared minus 16. This we can write as, how can we make it perfect square? Shall I write as 3xy the whole square? So that 3 squared 9, x squared y squared minus 16 can be written as 4 squared. So this looks like now a square minus b square. This is a, this is b. So what is a square minus b square? A plus b. 3xy plus 4 multiplied by 3xy minus 4. A plus B into A minus B. So, we have factorized 9x squared y squared minus 16 into 3xy plus 4 multiplied by 3xy minus 4. Next, 7th sum. X squared minus 2xy plus y squared minus z square. So, what is given? X squared minus 2xy plus y squared minus z square. Now, you can see this is a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. So, in place of a, we have x. In place of b, we have y. This is in the form of a square minus 2ab plus b square. Therefore, this will become x minus y the whole square and this minus z square given in the question. Now, this looks like for you now a square minus b square, where a is x minus y, b is z. So, what is a square minus b square? A plus b into a minus b. So, I can write a plus b into a minus b. X minus y plus z. X minus y minus z. Okay. The given question is x squared minus 2xy plus y squared minus z squared, which we can find this is the expansion of x minus y the whole square. You expand and see x square plus y square minus 2 into x into y. Then this minus z squared. Now, is look like a square minus b square, where a is x minus y, b is z. So, what is a square minus b square? A plus b into a minus b. So, a plus b, a plus b, a minus b. So, we have factorized x squared minus 2xy plus y squared minus z squared as x minus y plus z into x minus y minus z. Next, 8th sum. 25a squared minus 4b squared 28bc minus 49 c squared. 25a squared minus 4b squared plus 28bc minus 49c squared. So this we can write as, see, a squared here only you have, there is no a anywhere. But here you can see, this is b squared, bc, c squared. So this gives us an expansion of an identity, so which we can write as 25a squared. Here I take this minus out so that I can write this as 4b squared minus 28bc, because minus I have taken out. To get plus, minus minus plus. Again this will become plus because minus I have taken out, minus plus 49c squared. Now this you can see as 25a squared is 5a the whole squared minus this 4b squared minus 28bc plus 49c squared is 2b minus 7c the whole squared. 2b squared, 4b squared, 7c squared, 49c squared, 2ab, 2 2s are 4, 4 7s are 28bc. Now this looks like your a square minus b square, where your a is 5a and this full is b, 2b minus 7c. So we have a plus b, a plus 2b minus c, a plus b into a minus c. So a plus b multiplied by a minus b. Now we take the sign 5a plus 2b minus 7c. Here this will become 5a minus 2b minus minus plus 7c. Okay. So we have made, grouped it to make one identity, the second, third and fourth, in the form of 2b minus c, 7c the whole square. Then we got it as like a minus b the whole square, a squared minus b square, where for b we have two terms, which we split it into a plus b into a minus b, and we take the minus sign inside. So we got 5a plus 2b minus 7c, 5a minus 2b plus 7c. So the sums, the last two, three sums is a bit on the higher level, HOTS question. So watch this video twice or thrice to understand it. Okay. So just once if you see, and don't have a fear that you are not able to understand. If you are able to, because already I have explained you two or three times the same sum, you should have understood by now 50%. So watch the video again and again for two more times. You will get the solution correctly. Now next. So in this way we have completed our second main of this exercise. 14.2, second main we have completed. Now let us take third main. Third main also factorization. See now, in the first main we have used the identity a plus b the whole squared and a minus b the whole square. In the second main we have taken the identity a squared minus b squared. The third main is the combination of both that plus whichever term is common also, we will take it out and we factorize it. Okay. Now, in question number 3, factorize the expression ax squared plus bx. So, we can see x is common. So, we will write like this now. Ax squared plus bx. So, a and b are different. We can't take it out. X squared x. So, we can write x squared as x into x plus b into x. So, which is common now? You can see x is common in both the term. So, here ax is left out. Here plus b is left out, which we have factorized. Okay. So, ax squared plus bx. So as I said, for the common variable, you take the least power. So x squared and x, x is the least power. So if I take 1x out, in x squared, 1 is out. So how many more? Only one more. So ax, already this x is taken out from the second term. So plus b. So the first subdivision, ax squared plus bx is factorized into x into ax plus b. Now second subdivision, 7b squared plus 21q squared. In this we can see 7 and this we can write as 7 threes are 21. And the variables are different, p squared and q squared. So we cannot take a common term. So since 7 is common, we take 7 out. So we have p squared plus 3q squared. That is a factorization. After that, no, p squared and 3q squared, we don't have any common terms. So 7 into p squared plus 3q squared. Now third one, 2xq plus 2xy squared plus 2xz squared. You can see in all the three terms, 2 is common and x variable is common. So I take the least power of x. Here x cube, here x power 1, x power 1. So I take x power 1 out. So in the first term 2x cube, if I take 2x out, the remaining is x to the power of 2. Because in power 3, 1 power I have taken out, remaining 2 power is there. Plus, in the second term, 2x I have taken out, left is y squared. And in the third term again, 2x is out, left is z squared. So we got 2x into x squared plus y squared plus z squared. Now let us do question number 4. Am squared plus bm squared plus bn squared plus an squared. Okay. So in this, we can see we will group first two term, next two term. In the first two term, we can see m squared is common. So we take m squared out. So a and then second term plus b. Am squared plus bm squared. M squared is taken, we have taken out. So here a is left, here b is left. Now, the last two term, if you see, n squared is common, we will take it out. So what do you have now? B plus a. Now in this, I can write m squared a plus b, n squared b plus a also I can rewrite as a plus b. Because we know 2 plus 3 is equal to 3 plus 2, is it not? Both are 5. Same way, b plus a, in addition, when you change the position also, it is going to be the same. So b plus a, I rewrite as a plus b. So now when you see, for these terms, a plus b is common. Here a plus b, here a plus b. So we take a plus b out. So what do you have now? In the first term, m squared is left. In the second term, n squared is left. So am squared plus bm squared plus bn squared plus an squared. The given question, we group first two terms so that m squared is common, a plus b left over. In the last two term, n squared is common when we take out, again b plus a. So this b plus a we can rewrite as a plus b. Then we see a plus b is common. So in the first m squared is left, in the second term n squared is left. So the given expression is factorized into a plus b into m squared plus n squared. Okay. So we have done up to 4 subdivision. Complete up to this. Keep practicing. So we have done 2nd May in exercise 14.2 from page number 223, your exercise 14.2. Second main, all the 8 sum. In the third main, first 4 subdivision, we have completed. Watch the video. Keep practicing. Any doubts get clarified. In the next video, we will start from question number 5.